Hello Doctor Who fans, I am Doctor Who commentator here to give you my personal fan commentary on this year's Christmas special of Doctor Who. But first, a few disclaimers before we start. I'm not affiliated with the BBC in any way, I'm not affiliated with Doctor Who, I don't know anyone from Doctor Who, I do this purely for fun. Although, I should say, when I was watching this episode, there were people talking and it was funny and hard to concentrate, so I can't remember a great deal. Plus, I don't really think this was a great episode anyway, even though I shouldn't really be reviewing, I'm just commentating. I'm just setting up my facts here, and let's get on with the episode. Right, so already, we're on Earth. This is starting to sound very similar to my old special, and lots of people watched that, didn't they? Here we are, big looming spaceship. Yeah, great commentary this is. Then again, I am talking more than I did the first time. Or is it just about the same? They're all primed on Earth. And now it's blown up. I'm having a hard time deciding whether that CGI was any good or not. Right, here's the Doctor. And everyone's meant to think he's dead. Really a clever idea to suddenly burst out like that if everyone's meant to think you're dead. Just the music's okay. So I'm just trying to check the audios. Okay, I can't really hear under this hat. Right. Right. So he's surviving, despite there being no air. Although that said, trying to remember what the Fort's Doomsday. Yeah, I remember Fort's Doomsday. He has been able to survive the vacuum space before. So now he's lost the spacesuit. Now he's falling again, surviving for some reason. Oh, he's the Doctor. He can do anything. Oh shit, he's gonna die. Right, opening trailers as normal. There's not much I can come with that. Other than the fact I did find this a pretty boring episode. It's Stephen Moffat going through his regular phase. Say regular, he's only done one Christmas special before. In which he just uses average Christmas stories. I will give props to Davis, at least he continued the plot a bit rather than just trying to make this as Christmassy as possible. And I talked over the fact that Amy and Rory, Karen Gillian and I've forgotten his name. I should know these things! Their names weren't in the credits, but a Miss. And they just appeared, why do I not know things? Claire Skinner made an appearance. Arthur Darville! And now the Doctor's crash has made a huge crater. Why was the spacesuit not destroyed? Hello? You think someone would notice that? I mean, I know it's 1930 or 40, whatever. Not very good with when the war was. Not good with dates. How can you hurt him? I didn't put a spotlight on me. I'm sorry. I know that's not important. The moon's felt pounding. Too interesting. It's astronomy. Don't make up words. He was making up things and breathing. Where's your shop? In the garden. What are you doing in the garden? Agriculture. Lethal teenagers were even stroppy. Stroppy back in 1930s. That I found a spaceman in a field. Possibly an angel. But he's injured and I can't get his helmet off. It's not an angel. I'm amazed, but She thinks spacemen, but then very quickly thinks angels. That's impressive. Ah, that's Donna Armstrong. Previously, Mr. Smith. Not anymore. Yeah, I don't care how intensive that sounded. Oh, rubbish driver. Could be.
Repairing
you?
Yes.
That's the idea.
Won't it repair you back front?
No.
Well, that's good. Oh, sorry,
lad. Yes, I got that impression.
Round this way.
This is very old slapstick humour, isn't it?
Right. You're welcome to come to our house.
This whole police box thing. I'm rather surprised the joke in question hasn't been done before, frankly. Because I thought this is a joke which should have been done many times before. I'm rather surprised the police boxes aren't still around, because they are very useful inventions, frankly. The idea of putting someone in the police box before the police come. Yeah, I don't really care about being alone at Christmas myself. I'd rather enjoy it. I'm always confused. I'm actually confused by a spacesuit. Is it really the suit that's back to front, or is it just the helmet? Yep. A real police box. Why has that joke not been done before? What a point! Why is it on Earth? I would have thought it would be on that spaceship. It's 3 years later and war has started. Stiff upper lip. Keep calm. Get it on. How British we should be. I know this is a sad moment, but I just love the Britishness of it. Maybe that's why the Americans like it so much. Well, they don't completely take everything that is British from Doctor Who. That is just sad, actually.
When is Tom coming back? For Christmas, like he always does. Right, hurry up and think of something.
Well, we're going to Uncle Digby's house.
Will he be there? He will, won't he, Mother? Daddy will be there.
I'm rather surprised they haven't been evacuated already. The doctor's arriving. But now I really do have to learn some history, because I thought it was only the children that ever got evacuated, none of the adults did. But then again, they said they were going to their uncles, so maybe that's the reason. Yeah, pull the door off.
There we go.
For coming. Did you come?
How is she not recognized? I mean, I know it was his face, but surely she could recognize that voice. She should recognize that voice. Why would he say, take your...
I'm the caretaker. But you're not Mr. Carter.
I agree.
But I don't understand. Are you the new caretaker?
Usually call the doctor, or the caretaker, or get off this planet.
Speaking, that I like... isn't name. I do like that joke.
Hello.
He's got to know him very quickly. He's a very intelligent man. Televisions around back? I honestly don't know. That was probably handled by a bit of stop motion there. A lot of this is odd. Did they have taps back then? I'm really curious. Basically an escalator. This is very 11th Doctor, isn't it? This is something I'm always curious about Matt Smith's Doctor. He's a bit out there, but then again, he doesn't really feel like... I like to think he doesn't feel like much of a Doctor, but... then again, every Doctor is meant to be unique, and he does have quite a bit of Patrick Troughton in him. Even if Matt Smith himself probably doesn't realise it. All these things he gets for.
Where are the beds?
You have a huge space right there. This is notoriously difficult to get into.
Sounds like they've had a bit of fault.
Please stop talking. Can you please just stop?
Sorry.
This is being angry.
Why? We're leaving. Yes. No. I don't know. Just please go downstairs.
Cool. Well, take out your anger on them. You're brilliant, mother. Yeah.
Their father's dead.
Sorry.
Lily and Cyril's father. My husband is dead and they don't know yet. Because if I tell them now, then Christmas will always be what took their father away from them and no one should have to live like that.
Really? He died before Christmas.
When the Christmas period is over, I think.
You can't just... Maybe it's different back time, but you can't just let them not know. They have to learn. They'll have to know. I do hate it when people do stuff like that. Repaired the main sitting room. What's wrong with it? His bizarre idea of a Christmas tree. Those don't belong to the Roboform. That isn't one of the trees from the Roboforms, are they? God, I hope I got that name right. I can't be bothered to look it up. I'm talking about the robot Santas.
Quite ridiculous. You must stay away from him. I like him. I like him too. And
It's a nice tree, isn't it? It's the best tree in the park. Yes. Yes, I suppose it is.
Say it, Mother, go on, please. Say the thing you always say.
This Christmas is going to be the best Christmas ever.
There could not have been more cheesy. I was a bit confused watching that, because it got the impression that the present was dangerous, and I thought, why is the doctor giving him a dangerous present?
Lily!
Well, I'm all asleep now. I can't wait. All kinds of explosions and the sonic screwdriver. What could be better? What could be more dangerous, rather? She went to see what the present was. Typical child, wanting to see what the present is. At that time, they believe in Father Christmas. Only a bit curious why Father Christmas has given him a present early. Yeah, this isn't an ominous feeling. Why is it glowing? That's a bigger question. It's actually designed to glow. My famous last words. Well, she's an annoying girl. No, don't go in there! Oh, what do you know? Narnia! Interesting fact for anyone watching this later on, they didn't do a Doctor Who Confidential for this episode. I don't understand why. I wanted to see a Doctor Who Confidential for this episode, because I did want to hear a lot about it. Are they not doing them anymore? If the confidential's got boring now. Okay, she looked at that hammock, and as you'll hear later, she thinks that he is still in the bed. Yeah, that looked nothing like him. I always hate that part.
Still in bed, asleep.
Okay. Faulty then.
So he says. Heaven just knows, those are huge glasses. His eyes aren't really that bad. I'm kind of impressed that there's actually a planet which can have its own trees honestly look like they're growing decoration. That's just convenient. Only evolution can do. Yeah. You know, I do believe in evolution, so I'm gonna shut up. My point was I wasn't being sarcastic. But I am rather surprised evolution could do that. I know, it's really negative. It's sorry for yawning, I am a bit tired, I'm doing this commentary rather late. And we're only 20 minutes in, 40 to go. Yes, follow footprints, that's always good. Oh, really? It's not that clever. It's pretty old. They all do that. Get in. Mary. Anyway, a bit confused by the science behind this. Just a portal to the nether world. I mean, if it was a portal within the box, I'd understand. Rather, I'd understand why the time differences. So it's actually a fairyland. Are the ones he was following?
Notice anything? The other footprints are getting bigger.
Yes?
Yeah.
Whatever your brother's following, it's growing.
It's gonna get huge!
Well, then we have to get after him!
Oh, that was clever.
It's okay, you're fine. Don't worry.
Is that true? Alive.
Of course it's alive as a tree.
Is it dangerous?
Exactly. Has its thorns. Ugh, that's a horrible joke.
Christmas tree decorations.
Yeah, naturally occurring Christmas trees. Oh, how cool is that?
I don't understand.
It's a big universe. Everything happens somewhere. Call it a coincidence. Call it an idea echoing among the stars. Personally, I call it a brilliant idea for a Christmas trip, or it should have. Do you know the difference between wind and trees talking to each other?
What?
No wind. I've been here many times, but
I've never read Narnia, so, or seen the film, or I don't remember the old BBC TV series. Did the trees talk to each other in that? Because otherwise I imagine it's just that's taken from Lord of the Rings. I say as if I've read Lord of the Rings, I've only seen the films.
Sorry, Lily, I really am, but there is something very wrong in this forest. And your brother's right in the middle of it.
Citizen Cyril Arwell, where are you?
You've only just noticed? How is she now? Surely she should be asleep. Sorry, sorry, Leland. Like I said, I am very tired today. Oh, now she's walked into it. Lovely. Oh, Cyril's found a building. Old wooden building. He's not going to be tired after he climbs all those steps. When you're that age, you never like walking. I certainly didn't. Now the king is sitting in his throne. Confused about that. I'm confused why there aren't any more of those things. I mean, there's only two trees in the shape of people. Or is that a Narnia thing? I literally don't know! Yep, there is something dangerous there. I'm finding the CGI for that machine to be rubbish. Just a little bit rubbish anyway. Oh, soldiers. They look like hello soldiers. To be honest. I think. Now, I know Bill Bailey, but who are the other two? Sure, the other two are my parents did tell me the woman there is a comedian, but I've no idea who the other guy is. Sure, all three are comedians. Oh, God. What do you do when a girl starts crying? Oh, that's not ominous. Ominous. Now back to the doctor. Back to the doctor and the annoying little girl. No. Thankfully, Christmas trees aren't called Christmas trees, they're called pine trees. Exactly.
So a forest grows a building. That's their honey and honey trap.
Because it's a trap.
Exactly. Think about people we can never resist a door.
So this is a trap.
We've just walked straight into a trap.
People trap question is, why does a forest need people?
That's a good question.
We should go. We have to get out of here.
There's Cyril's here.
So let's find Cyril.
Mum, crying. I can't interrogate you while you're crying. This is a military engagement. There's no crying in military engagement. Corporal Ven-Garr, are you?
They're just being their comedian selves, aren't they? Well, I think Bill Bailey's appearance might have been a bit overhyped.
With regret, I'm going to have to lower my gun. She is a crying, unarmed, female civilian. I'm thinking of the visual.
Nobody's looking.
Doesn't mean there's no visual.
That's exactly what nobody's looking.
I'm sorry, sir.
Want me to shoot her,
sir?
Oh,
visual
deteriorating. Shut up.
What are you
doing? I am respecting her as a woman, sir.
Okay, we're putting our guns on the ground. Okay? Happy now? We're stepping away from our guns. Now can we interrogate you? We're from Androzani Major.
Yeah. Ah, Androzani Major, as in the caves of Androzani.
England, 1941, and there's a war on.
Don't really do anything against that kind of armour.
If you say so, but there's nothing you could say that would convince me you'd ever use
that
gun.
Well, I'm looking for my children.
Seriously? That's the cheesiest thing I've ever seen. Oh no, a crown! Exactly! Yes, that's referring to the episode The End of the World. Cross my leg. Cross my leg, I look intelligent. Yep, trees have life.
Life force. Pure life force. Just love. Singing.
Beautiful.
Yes.
Isn't it crying?
Ugh. I hate beautiful things. He's alive! Why was he virtually immobile when he was in the seat though? There are a lot of issues with this episode, frankly. George.
Androzani trees. Greatest fuel source ever. The entire area is being melted down with battery fluid.
Melted down? How do you melt a forest?
Acid rain. Satellites are in position. Anyone still out there in 5 minutes is going to burn.
Oh dear. crush him. No, it doesn't work on wood.
What's wrong with him? Can't they guess that he's dead?
It's okay. He's just unconscious. What are you then? Not a king? Queen! The queen bee of the forest.
Caretaker.
They're still shining.
It's like.
Like what?
Like the life forces leaving the forest.
Of course, they're trying to escape. What else? This is a peaceful planet, you said it. It's a very gentle planet. They're wood!
Aliens made of wood!
You think he could have developed an app so that it could work on wood? Yeah, it's very friendly. Ah, telepathy. Oh, good. Oh, come on! Seriously? Why aren't they evacuating their technology, though? That's what I don't understand. Has he not got acid rain yet? No, he hasn't. Why did it take him a while? He is gonna burn. Look like a crown, like a golden ring on her. He haven't hurt him yet. What do you think I'm gonna hurt him now? I can't do much else. Yeah, that's probably a reference to both the Fez and the Stetsons. Oh, not good. Yeah, he is a strong... I don't know why they kept saying he's weak, because he's a very strong guy. And a mere human can. Why didn't it affect Cyril the same way? Because the whole big reveal in this, why didn't it affect Cyril in the same way? It affected the Doctor so painfully. The imprint of the crown is still there. Now he knows what it is.
Acid rain.
So he won't survive 2 minutes. Shall we save in the machine? Stop making noise.
The way we came here, that door won't stay open forever. Now, I'm not even sure if I can get us through the forest safely, but if we're gonna have any chance at all, we have to go now.
No. We wait for Mummy. Ugh. Mummy always comes.
What a stroppy chum.
I'm sorry. I've not missed it.
The entrance on the holster. The thing is about that entrance on the holster, I've only just realized it's got 3 legs. It's like one of the tripods from War of the Worlds. How on earth is she piloting that? Rubbish. Oh, that's a horrible joke. Oh, they still need to escape. Early. Oh. Oh, women and jewelry. They found a host. She seems to be blind.
You've got a whole world inside your head.
I know. It's funny, isn't it? One can't imagine being a forest, and really one can. How remarkable.
Has anyone ever tried? I think that's not blind.
That wasn't me. Well, this is all really rather clever, isn't it?
She's strong. Ooh, ooh. Stupid me.
Yes.
The base code of nature itself. You and I, Cyril, we're weak, but she's female. More than female, she's mum. How else does life ever travel? The mothership.
Oh. That's a ridiculous translation. Mother and mothership are two completely different things. Plus, it didn't exactly hurt Cyril. My parents laughed at that line. Hold tight, pretend it's a plan. So now they're going in the dark vortex. Oh, I just realised. I was going on earlier about how the time zones are different, and I completely forgot that the planet they were on was in the future. 5000 something. Yes, so now it all. Now the whole thing with that box makes sense. And now they've gotta get to a new time. They don't wanna stay in their own time. Yep. It's gonna have to be. Yes, think about the fact that he's dead. Geronimo! He should have said Geronimo. Show them time itself. Very happy families. Different time, because in any other situation, he'd be a stalker. You never saw it anyway, to be fair. We're gonna find out eventually. This is all very sad. Oh my god, it's a bright light! You know, they normally say don't go into the light. I will admit, that was all very nice. Stupid ending. Never put too much stock in the Christmas specials, I say. They've been very distrusting all of a sudden. What does it say? Please just tell us! Oof. Very sad.
I prefer to be alone.
I don't believe anyone would prefer that. Stay close, caretaker.
I'll be right outside.
I prefer to be alone, Franklin. Drawing the story out. He's dead. Okay, he isn't. So. Nowadays, they probably use sat nav. Very serious look on the doctor's face. Straighten his bow tie.
No stars to light Waymarsh. There was one. There was you. What is it? I don't know. But it's all we've got. We can follow it.
I don't quite understand where you get that logic. And several other men. Mother Christmas. Terrible. Isn't someone going to notice that plane? Not to mention the giant dome.
Happy crying. Humany womany.
Happy families. Along with the tune to Silent Night. That's all we need. Now you recognize it. He doesn't do that.
Ah, well, you see, things to do, people to see.
Of course, yes. Family of your own.
Well, no, actually.
Oh. Yes, you say I have no family.
See, now that makes me curious, because that indicates that he really, Susan is dead. Or he just genuinely doesn't know. And people think he's dead. The last of the Time Lords is dead. Cool, you don't know the situation, don't order him. Don't badger him about on things you don't know.
Now, eyes on the box.
I require you again?
Make a wish.
Is this some indication that he's going to be back next year? There he goes. Never call them the doctor. Just the kid. Yep. I hate Carol singers too. Always annoying.
But absolutely sure. How long?
2 years?
Except they knew he was alive.
River told us.
Well, of course she did.
She's a good girl.
She's her daughter.
I'm not gonna have first.
Nor am I.
Well, neither one can resist. I'm curious now, if he said not quite sure how long, how many years have passed for him then? Then again, how much is a Gallifreyan year? That's odd. Of course, Amy and Rory are coming back. And of course, next series will be their last series. It'll be a big, beautiful, dramatic ending for them. Yeah, sure it will. Although I will say, I will be glad when Amy's gone. Anyone who's seen my previous commentaries will know very much how I feel about her. Although the one thing that's truly annoyed me about this episode is there's no trailer for the next series. They've not finished it yet. Right, so that was my fan commentary for Doctor Who. I have been Doctor Who commentator. I also have another YouTube account, Bacora23, and if you, and I'm not on Facebook or Twitter or anything like that, but I also have an account on the forum for Doctor Who World, which is Omega One. Thank you for listening. I hope you've enjoyed it. Hang on. And goodbye.